Hello, Facebook.
Hello, Facebook.
All right.
How the goes in ya?
Rhys Ifans, can you believe that?
I've never done this before.
You've never done a Facebook Live?
No, this is properly live. Can't believe it's just on the phone.
Yeah, proper so we've taken his Facebook Live virginity now.
Yep, that's it. It's all happening tonight.
Yeah.
So stick around because we might have some more interesting things to chat about with Rhys. So I think we're about to go live on the telly now.
We are. How long have we got? 30 seconds until we are live. So just before the break that we went into then, we were speaking to Rhys. He's been doing into film
at
Plasmauer School.
School
Plasmauer.
Just before the break.
Fairwater, yeah.
So he's been doing that all day. And you've been with BAFTA Cymru today.
I'm with BAFTA Cymru this afternoon in Cineworld doing another kind of Q&A encouraging... hopefully, and illuminating young people again who want to enter into the film industry or the TV industry or whatever. So
fantastic. Now we're still on the Facebook Live, Rhys. We've got to go back to live.
Yeah.
So
this is
ready?
Amazing.
So much live.
How'd you do it?
Here we go.
This is the future of radio.
Hello, you've joined us back on the radio.
It's like radio with pictures.
Rhys Ifans is still here. We're going to be chatting to him in a minute. But make sure you're heading to our Twitter page as well to enter into our poll for this evening. It's European Day of Languages. We want to know how many do you speak?
And we'll take a look inside Tramshed's recent tech event to help make Cardiff a smart city.
Still with us live, as I just said on the French, the one and only Welsh actor and musician that is Rhys Ifans. Thanks for sticking around.
Oh, you're very welcome.
So, I want to talk now more about your roles in film, if we may.
Mm-hmm.
I want to talk about Spike. Surely you get a lot of pants. Does anyone ever ask you about your nice firm buttocks?
No, well, the thing is, what's happened with the underpants situation is there are several pants now that claim to be my
just floating around.
My knickers, yeah. They're not, you know, there was only one bit, I don't know where they are, but a friend of mine a while back, who shall remain nameless, because it's probably illegal what he did, got me to sign about 40 pairs of pants, you know, which then he proceeded to try and sell to various establishments across the world, saying they were the original. But I don't know what happened.
But when you were doing Notting Hill, when you were shooting it, you can't have imagined, like, the success it would have had afterwards. I mean, for you, was it just like, this is just another film, it's another job?
No, well, I mean, you know, I knew it was because they'd done Four Weddings and a Funeral beforehand, and that was a huge success. So, I knew it was kind of a big film, but I didn't really understand how massive it would be. And at the time, it was the kind of biggest selling comedy of all time, you know. So it kind of went out of control a little bit, and I wasn't at all prepared for that, you know. I didn't actually realise that my part in the film was as big as it turned out to be in the film, you know. But, you know, the directors and the editors and the studio seemed to love Spike so much, they kind of really used everything I did, pretty much, you know, and even little add-ons and what have you. So, yeah, my world changed quite dramatically after that, without me really letting it sink in, you know. And it kind of dawned on me when maybe, you know, a few months later I was in Brazil or South Africa, or, you know, and then I went to India at some point, and there was, like, you know, lepers knew who I was in India, you know what I mean?
Wow.
So it's like kind of and in America, so it was like kind of this weird feeling that I'd never had before, where people in a foreign country where you expect to be completely and utterly anonymous know who you are. It's pleasant and deeply paranoid making in equal measure, but of course by now it's something hopefully I've come to terms with. But you know, it's not up there with the greatest experiences in life, I have to say.
Now I think next we should talk about Twin Town. Amazing.
Yeah.
Probably 20 years.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I think they just recently, which I unfortunately couldn't go to, had a celebration in Swansea, actually, an open air screening of it, and with a great turnout.
And we did see your message.
I mean, of all the films, oh, you saw that.
We did see your message. We can't play that right now.
But it's still of all the films I've ever done, it's the one that's closest to my heart. You know, for the obvious reasons that it was shot in Wales, with a Welsh crew and a Welsh cast and a Welsh director and a Welsh writer. It was like, you know, a made in Wales product, you know, the likes of which has, you know, never been seen since, you know. So I'm really proud of it. And, you know, to this day, you know, you can see whole families across Wales will sit around the table and reenact scenes, you know, and it's always quite, you know, I don't know, it puts a smile on my face when you see a 4-year-old boy saying some of the lines.
I can imagine.
But it happens, you know, and I think, you know, it's one of those films that really kind of got under our skin as a nation and stayed with us, and I'm really, really proud to be part of it, and hopefully, you know, there'll be another one at some point.
Would you
want to be part of that?
Oh well, absolutely. Hopefully, I will be. You know, I mean, there was all good intentions to shoot it this year, this summer, but there was a slight delay. I think it was herd of beavers that have been introduced to West Wales, just outside Llanelli. These are big, big, hairy beavers, and they've.
Do go on, Rhys.
So where was I? Big hairy beavers, West Wales. Yeah. So basically, what these beavers have done is we were going to film in a little valley, and the beavers went ahead and built a dam, and the dam's burst, and it's flooded our set.
I did not think that would be the reason.
No, I think it's probably the first film that's been delayed because of too much beaver.
That's a great story. It's a great
show.
Another good story.
So hopefully next year, you know, we'll have dealt with the situation. We'll have settled.
No more beavers.
Yeah.
So another good story that a little birdie has told us is that apparently you've had a snog with Daniel Craig. Is this true that you were the first ever Bond girl?
Well, no. Tell us more. I was paid to do it, obviously, and so was he. You know, no, it was a film called Enduring Love, which I did many years ago, an Ian McEwan film, and at the end of the film, I play his stalker, and at the end of the film, I had to kill his wife, played by Samantha Morton, and then I had to basically kiss him, and it was very uncomfortable for both of us.
Nice story for that Christmas, though, isn't it?
I had my tongue in someone with a license to kill.
Not many people can say that, though.
No.
So what about the future, Rhys? You've got a lot of projects coming up, new films you're working on?
No, I'm heading back to London tonight because I'm living there at the moment, and I'm rehearsing A Christmas Carol. Charles Dickens is A Christmas Carol.
You're playing Scrooge, aren't you?
And I'm playing Scrooge. I'd like to think there was another 10 years till I was to play that. So maybe they're desperate or I'm versatile. I don't know what the answer to that is. But I'm really excited to be doing that. It's a new adaptation by Jack Thorne, who just wrote the Harry Potter show that's on in the West End at the moment, and he wrote some Star Wars scripts as well. He's an incredible writer, and it's Matthew Walkers, who directed another great Welsh film called Pride. He runs the Old Vic Theatre in London, so it's on. If you're from Wales or Cardiff and you're coming to London to see the show, please come. The kids are 11 plus, because it's quite scary in bits. And if you're from Wales, come to stage door after, and I'll properly say hello. Yeah.
Lovely. What an invite. How about that? Lovely.
Rhys, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you on. Thank you so much.
Do you know what, Mike? What time is it, man?
Have you got to get a train?
No, my train's... I'm going to miss... No, I won't miss it. I've got to go.
He's going to have to go. He's got to get a train.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas. He said that. I'm so happy. But we do now have to get a news update.